We're going to move into a time of prayer together. And our song is 178, Jesus Keep Me Near the Cross, their precious fountain, free to all healing stream flows from Calvary's mountain. In the cross, be my glory ever, till my raptured soul shall find rest beyond. We're going to be remembering those who need our prayers in special ways today, those who are sick, those who are mourning, especially Mildred's family. And we pray for the Lord to work and move in our lives and in our communities during this Easter season. We'll sing the first two verses together.
Thank you.
Precious God, we just come before you again today, and we come on behalf of others. We just want to take these few moments to lift before you all those who are on our hearts and our minds today. And we each come with so many different people, so many different connections, so many different needs that we know about. And yet we also know that you are a great and awesome God who knows each and every single one of them personally. They can minister personally. And so that's what we pray today. That your Spirit would work and would move, would lift burdens, would comfort the grieving, would bring hope to the despair, to give strength to the weary. Father, you know that life is amazing. You watched your Son walk these very steps that we walk, the different struggles of life, the grief of losing those we love. And so, Father, we pray that you be with us as you were with him. And we think especially of Mildred's family today. We pray, Father, that your arms of eternal love and comfort would be around them. That they would learn to rest in you. That they would learn to cling to you for your strength, for your grace, and for their eternal salvation. We thank you for the impact that Mildred has had in this core for so many years. Such a faithful servant. We give thanks for her life. And we pray, Father, that her life will continue, the memories of her will continue to make an impact in this church and in the communities along this part of the world. Because we know, Father, that she was a faithful, loving, compassionate servant of God. And so we pray, Father, that we would learn from her. And that we would step into the gap to be there for her family as they move through these difficult times. Be with those, Father, in our seniors' homes, our nursing homes, our hospitals. Those who are at home, but yet, Father, suffering such great agonies. We pray your Spirit of healing would be upon them. We pray for those who have financial trouble, relationship troubles. Oh, Father, that you move in their midst. You would minister to them and you would provide what is needed in each of their difficult situations. And Father, we pray now as we open your word. And as we look back at this day that we're commemorating your Son's life, that you would teach us once again the depth of your love and the power of your grace in our lives. In your Son's name we pray.